Hello guys, my name is Fox and welcome to part 17 of our Raja of the Rajputronic achievement run in Europa Inner South 4. Let's continue. So, in the previous episode, we've not been declaring any wars, because we can't really attack anyone right now without drawing the attention of a lot of allies from their side, so that's kind of unfortunate. But yeah, we've been just trying to core the provinces we got from Melwar, because they're really freaking expensive to core, since this Rajput traditions. But yeah, we're growing our army. Our force limit is actually getting quite significant. Also, this Melwar Separatist is already at 80%, so I should be paying attention. Yeah, just coring stuff, just converting stuff, everything is great, mostly. Unfortunately, we have too few rivals, and I don't know who to rival, really. It's probably gonna be Gujarat and Multan if I were to choose, but they both still, or these three guys are still allied, and I'm also allied with them, so if I were to rival or try to attack any of them, I would have to fight with Jaunpur. Yeah, I would have to fight with Jaunpur anyways, and Jaunpur is actually kind of powerful. Oh, I don't like it at all. Actually, Himalaya have a pretty similar color to Jaunpur, so it's kind of hard to see what's happening. Okay, 90% on Melwar Separatists. Let's actually go and sit on Melwar, because it's actually now... but Cheetor actually have... Yeah, I need to switch on Fortress on Cheetor and sit on Melwar, because Melwar is currently Corrin, and if these guys were to siege it, I think Corrin process would actually be cancelled. And we also have Delian Separatists. Is it because I'm... why is it so? Oh, because a recent uprising, I guess, went away. But at least it's now our religion, so we do not have an intolerance. And separatism slowly gonna go down, so should not be too much of a problem, I hope. Also, now we are losing money, because supporting this fort. But actually, it's fine. Oh, we only have 9 stacking here, that's cool. Also, we have our infantry combat ability now, thanks to our... quality ideas. So that should help as well. Actually, we're about to get ourselves second idea. That's cool. Should we wait on morale? Probably not really. Also, Multan would be willing, looks like, to help me in here, but it's already too late. Let's switch off this fort again. And now we could definitely drop our maintenance on troops by quite a lot. Okay, anyone. Gujarat, you should stop being allied with Jaunpur. Because he's preventing me from attacking Sindh. This guy preventing me from attacking Gujarat and attacking Multan. Malwa, I could attack him, but he's gonna get protected by Bahmanis, and I'm kind of afraid of that. Should I just wait 5 years and call in Gujarat as well in here? Gujarat have pretty decent sized army. Or actually, or maybe Multan and Jaunpur gonna be enough. Let me check again. Bahman is 19 plus Malwa 9, so it's 28. And plus some vassals, so it's gonna be like 35,000. In total, my enemies, or my allies actually have more, and also I have my own army. So technically we could win this, but I would really prefer to have more advantage, or as much as advantage as I possibly can have. Also, Melwar is about to finish Corrin, so it's probably not gonna give me more gold income. I have no idea. Let's go and check it. No. I think... maybe autonomy affects it? No idea. So... what are we gonna do? Yeah, we're losing power projection like crazy because not having enough rivals. Not attacking anyone. Conquer Revokanta. That's actually really tempting. So I'm gonna take this mission. I already have claims on everything in here. Could possibly take... Yeah, having Gujarat would be really freaking useful. Because he's gonna draw the attention of Bahmanis at least on his sieges, and he's gonna give time to Janpur and Multan to arrive. And just to siege all of that. Also, Sindh is getting attacked by Baluchistan or other way. Defender against Baluchistan. Baluchistan a conqueror of Kandahar. Oh. So this guy attacked Timurids and Timurids are allied with Sindh. Okay. That's why Gujarat is not in here. But it would be great if the Baluchistan were actually to take this province. So then I could attack Baluchistan and start expanding in here. Because Sindh is unavailable for me for now. Nothing happens with Bahmanis? No. No one can really attack him, unfortunately. And also, if I were to wait for too long, Bengal would join on the side of this guy. 4 years. Is it worth waiting? Probably. What I could do with this 4 years? Not much, really. Just get points for my ideas and convert everything. Okay, two more provinces left. Already season on Cheater. That should be fine. They already have an uprising, so they're not gonna be rebelling while I'm converting them, I'm pretty sure. Our new mission. Oh yeah, I took this conquest. Dorp. Actually, I'm too lazy to wait. I probably shouldn't be waiting for Solon. I need to expand as much as I possibly can. So Multan and Janpur against Bahmanis, this guy and his vassals, plus my army. I think we should be able to handle them. I really hope so, at least. Yeah, 4 years. In 4 years I could just core all of this. And maybe get myself a new rival in like Bahmanis. And just avoid attacking Gujarat, because if I were to take this province, I would be able to attack Baglana, give myself river access, not that I need it really, or ocean access rather. Yeah. I don't really need to expand this direction, but I don't really have other choice right now. Okay, let's go and raise our army maintenance. And let's see what we're gonna do in here. Any better generals we could receive? We do not have slots for generals. Could we get any of our guys? I could try to get our heir. He's not that great. 11 points in total. Yeah, let's go and make him into the general. Let's see what's gonna happen. General out of my heir. 2. Yeah, that's awful. How's technology looking? Oh, Janpur is still at level 7. Oh, you're so awful. Isn't level 8 a tactics level? No, okay. At least that's something. This guy's at level 8. So, should I take him right now? Maybe. Yeah, Gujarat, 4 years is a little bit too long. Okay, let's just try it. If my calculations are right, we should be able to win. Our alliance should be able to win. So, yeah, let's just declare a war for what? Revahant, I have a fort in here, so that's not great. Actually, have forts. Have a lot of forts. How could I actually see it easier? Like force map mod? No. There should be some map mod. Fort level. So you just have 2 forts in here and... Okay, maybe I should like have Chandari as a war goal then. And then take these 3 provinces and maybe even some provinces from his vassal. Actually, if we look at sieges Rivahanda province, it's gonna be hard for them to unsiege it. But Rivahanda, this guy for sure have a claim, but actually he's not gonna be the part of the war, so never mind. This guy have, oh, core on Kalpi and claim on Bundelkhand, so he's probably not gonna transfer it to me at all. What if I were to attack this guy? Bachmann is still would join. Yeah, it's better to attack Malwa because he's my rival after all. Let's just declare for Rivahanda. I know it's fort and all, but oh well. And let's actually switch on our forts before I'm gonna forget. Let's wait one more month for them to seek to get reinforcements. Okay. And call you in and attack for Rivahanda. Sounds fine. Oh, Mandasaur actually have no reinforcements. Could I siege it right away? Yeah, it have zero defenders, so I should be able to siege it in one tick. Let's go to speed 3 just in case. Okay, Mouton is moving. Janpur, you also should start moving here. Oh, there's the army of Bahmanis. But we have Mouton on this side, so that's fine. If they were to attack me here on Highlands, we should be able to defend. Oh, he's actually engaging. With minus one penalty. Okay. Mouton, how about you're gonna help me in this battle, please? Yeah, just engage, you jerk. We have a lot of combat ability on our infantry, so that should help. Have a lot of cannons on the back. This also should help. And... oh, but Bachmanis have discipline. Well, that's fine, yeah. The battle gonna be won. And hopefully my guys just... my ally is gonna go for the armies, and I'm just gonna go for the war goals and stuff. The army can suffer 10 prestige or lose manpower. Let's lose prestige for now. Or should I just go not for war goal? Yeah, I should go for these provinces before Janpur would be able to siege them. Like Bundelkhand and Kalpi. Oh, he's going for them right away. You jerk. Yeah, he knows that... it's actually his claims, so that's why he's willing to focus them so much. Mouton now gonna go for Borgol, I assume. No, he just can't... he just can't decide. Okay. Is this gonna get resieged automatically or not? I hope not. We lost a claim on the province. Kangra. Kangra is fine. Not because we're not losing claims on these provinces. Okay, Mouton, go destroy this army. What's gonna be useful? Also, a lot of cannons. We're getting actually 3 bonus. Looks like, yeah, Mouton giving me 2 more cannons. So we're receiving 3 artillery bonus. No bonus from our generals, unfortunately. And you just sacrificed your one stack in here for some reason. Are you crazy or what? Where are you going now? To Mando. Okay, that's fine. Destroy his armies while you can. I'm gonna siege on my own. I'm not gonna give Janpur Kalpi, because it's gonna make him stronger and I don't like it at all. This guy gonna engage in here. Why? 4-0-1. They have 1-1-3. So, is there a river crossing? There is a river crossing. But looks like Janpur armies are actually kind of weak. Yeah, they're not gonna win this battle. It's awful. Lose prestige, mercenary cost and available mercenaries, or lose 10 prestige and get local unrest. I don't care about mercenaries. I'm not using them. Also, we could invest into another one idea. They're probably gonna do this. Yearly army tradition. Yeah, that's actually gonna help. Quite a lot, hopefully. Okay, John Poor, could we please not lose these bottles? Be kind of useful. Is Molten now gonna sacrifice his army in here as well? Please don't. Actually, this guy's not gonna reinforce because their morale is too low. John Poor, how far away are you gonna retreat? Quite far away. Okay, at least he destroyed like two stacks in here. Nagor gains a diplomatic insult against Ladakh. I don't care about diplo insult. Let's just try to get opinion. Okay, we've got breached walls and already zero siege progress. Okay. Okay. Molten, now you're gonna win or lose in here. What the hell are you doing, guys? Please stop dying separately. I don't want to break this siege, so that's why I'm just sitting here and ignoring them. But that's kind of annoying, you know? These battles are actually costing a lot of war score. Okay, you're gonna try to siege Mandasaur. You're probably not gonna succeed. I'm just gonna go and attack you after this siege gonna be finished. Also, why are armies reinforcing so slowly? I don't know, but this guy now moving for me. And what about... Okay, John Poor is moving this direction, so hopefully you're gonna reinforce me if I would need it. We have heals bonus in here. Heals defense if needed. Because yeah, this guy's now gonna attack me. John Poor, are you gonna be able to get here in time? No idea. Probably no. Please, John Poor. Lose piety, gain piety. Let's get some. Please, John Poor. No, he's not gonna reach it in time. God damn it! But they now have low morale, so John Poor should be able to kill them, right? And I've lost all of this siege progress. And all of this manpower. Come on, John Poor, if you're gonna lose this battle, I'm gonna kill you. For real. God damn it, you're so awful. And of course, why the heck siege progress lost if actually the battle war been like continuing? Actually, no, for one day, when the John Poor failed to arrive, the siege actually had been broken. God damn it! Okay, looks like we need to like focus on battles a little bit. Also, we could invest into the diplo right now. Trade range, naval morale. Yeah, let's do this. Let's go and destroy these little stacks while they're around. Also, why do we have a mercenary in here? I've not been building mercenaries. What the heck? We have taken a loan. But I'm sure I have not been building mercenaries. That's weird, but okay. Maybe I misclicked something. Let's go and destroy this stack. It's heals and all, but we have a lot more troops. And actually, let's go and try to siege Kalpi now, if possible. While the John Poor is not doing this. Kalpi and Bundelkant. Okay, this guy's got breached walls. Hopefully they're gonna be able to finish the siege. Tyrhut something something, okay. I need to defend this mercenary. Nagor occupied Bundelkant, okay. What is mercenary maintenance in here? Probably under army maintenance. Yeah, a lot of battles got lost stupidly, but we are still winning this war, I'm pretty sure. Even though my manpower is almost at zero, and Janpur and Mulden probably lost a lot of manpower as well. But we're about to siege Borgol and we're about to siege Zissing, so hopefully I'm gonna be able to take these five provinces. And this would be glorious. Okay, come on, succeed. No, 28. That's fine. 28 in here too. Actually, it's already time for me to have a break, guys, so I guess I'm gonna do this right now. And we're gonna continue in the next episode, and hopefully we're gonna finish this war and gonna take a lot of land. We'll see. So, if you enjoyed watching this, you could leave a like. If you want to see more, you could subscribe. And if you want to leave a comment, you should definitely do it. And I would answer you as soon as I could. See you later, guys. Bye-bye.